In this tutorial, you'll learn how to set up a tablet coder simulation in EDEM using polyhedral particles. First, let's start by setting the units for the model. Next, define a new bulk material and define its properties. Add the material interaction coefficients. Add a polyhedral particle shape and name it. Next, import the particle CAD geometry and use the following setting to mesh. Then select Properties and tick Auto Calculation. For this tutorial, we are mixing two identical tablet types. Right-click on the material 1 and copy the material. Rename the new material and particle generated. The new material has the same properties and interaction of tablet 1. Next, create an equipment material called steel and add material properties. Add interactions between all the materials in the simulation. Next, import the coder geometry. Set the units to millimeters and use the following import parameters. Merge the four blades geometries. Rename this newly merged geometry to blades. And rename the main body of the geometry to drum. The next step is to specify the geometry dynamics. For this simulation, we'll add a linear rotation kinematic to the drum geometry. Set the start time to 1 second to allow the particles to settle before the rotation starts. Then, you have to specify the initial velocity and axis of rotation. To add the same linear rotation to the blade's geometry, you have to select under the parent options, drum. This will allow the blades to follow the drum motion. Next, we have to create the particle factory that will generate the tablets and set its properties. Copy the first factory. Rename the factory to factory top. Change the start time to easily see the two different tablet types being created, and ensure you select the table 2 under material. Note that this tutorial uses the default physics models for EDEM. The settings are for the Hertz-Mindlin model and standard rolling friction with spinning friction for polyhedral particles. Once you have completed setting up your model in the creator, move to the simulator. Next, you have to configure the simulator settings. For this simulation, uncheck the auto time step option. Set the fixed time step. Run the simulation for 6 seconds. And set the target save interval. This simulation uses polyhedral particles and requires a compatible NVIDIA GPU. Under advanced settings, set the precision mode to hybrid. Move to the analyst to visualize the mixing efficiency. First, change the color of one particle type. Then, replay the simulation and observe the mixing quality over time. You'll notice that after several rotations, the mixing of the tablets improves significantly. Next, we can use bin groups to analyze the number of particles of each type in a specific area of the drum. First, make sure the particles are no longer displayed in the viewer window. Next, create a new grid bin group with the following settings. You can define queries for number of particles, and there are several options for analyzing your bulk material using bin groups. Before continuing with the tutorial, set the bin group display mode to never. Next, we'll use continuum analysis to evaluate the mixing. To do that, first add a continuum item. Add a plane with the following settings. Adding a plane will create a single plane in the center of the simulation domain. After setting up the plane, you can generate continuum data. There are several attributes to choose from, and for this tutorial, we will select solid fraction and particle concentration. Under display options, choose solid fraction with the following settings. The data browser displays detailed information about your model. Keep in mind that the information displayed varies depending on whether you are using the creator, simulator, or analyst component of EDEM. Next, to evaluate the mixing process, you can plot the number of contacts between the particle types. Once the number of contacts reaches a steady value, this would indicate that the material is fully mixed. Next, you can study the trajectory of individual particles using manual selections. Here, we can see the two different particle types within the drum. Next, select the base manual selection. Under Type Filter, choose Particle Tablet 1. Ensure the Enable Manual Selection box is checked. This will allow you to select one or more particles. For this tutorial, we will select one particle of each type. Similarly, create another manual selection for particle type 2 and name it top. Select particle tablet 2. If several particles are chosen under the same manual selection, you can specify the required particles using the manual selection option. We can display the base and top manual selections as streams. First, deselect the Display All Particles option. Then, under Selections, change the representation setting to Stream. Ensure Stream All Steps is active. Finally, select a color. Repeat these steps for the other manual selection, and choose a contrasting color. Finally, play the simulation for 6 seconds. The trajectory of each particle will show that, regardless of their initial position, none of the material types remain stationary. Instead, they move around the drum evenly. This final part is optional, but if you'd like to calculate the mixing index, you might want to check out the Altair community. There, you'll find detailed steps and a script for computing the temporal evolution of the Lacey mixing index for a binary mixture of particles. Find additional EDEM tutorials in Altair community.